Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the Get Mo Wine video series. I'm your host, Pat Dodd, the Wine Dodd, and today we are coming to you from Camp 4, a great wine cafe here in Modesto, California. Today we're going to talk about something that I've been asked hundreds of times over the last 30 plus years in the industry, and that is, Pat, what is the best wine glass to drink this wine out of? Well, the easy answer to that question is one that doesn't leak. Duh. But seriously, through the years, I've thoroughly enjoyed drinking wine out of just about any shape, size, material of glassware imaginable. In fact, I've been even known to just pick up the bottle and drink out of it if we need to. But today we're going to talk about the four shapes that I consider to be essential, and they're the four shapes that we have in our home. And they're in front of us right here. We'll go through each one, talk to you a little bit about what each does differently than another, and which wines I recommend you drink out of them. And the four shapes are a sparkling wine stem, like you see here, a standard wine glass or white wine stem that you have here, and then this is kind of a larger bowl stem, oftentimes known as a Pinot Noir or a Burgundy shape, and then also a larger bowl but a different shape and configuration, and this is called the Cabernet or the Bordeaux blend shape. And I'll talk to you about each one of these as we go. Let's start with the sparkling wine flute. Now, some of you may be familiar with the other type of champagne glass that looks more like a big bowl. The problem with that style glass is when you put a sparkling wine, like a Prosecco, a Champagne, a Cava, Lambrusco, when you put that wine into this glass, the thousands and thousands and thousands of bubbles want to come up. If you have a much larger opening at the top of this glass, those bubbles are going to come out much faster. So the smaller the opening at the top of the glass, the slower the bubbles leave the liquid. So if you want the bubbles of your sparkling wine to last all the way to the end of the glass, make sure that you serve it in a flute like this with a narrow top. Next, we have the standard wine glass or the standard white wine glass. Now, you might notice it's a very similar shape to the Bordeaux glass that I showed you earlier, but the Bordeaux glass is a much larger bowl. Much more air can get into this glass, and we'll talk about that when we get to it. But here, this is a perfect shape and size for any type of dry white wines, aromatic white wines like Rieslings, Sauvignon Blancs, things like that, dry rosés, any grape variety, sweet reds, and just about anything that you can enjoy in this. And if you only own one wine glass in your home, make it be something along these lines. Now we're going to turn to the larger bowl glasses, and I'm going to tell you why you might want to consider having them in your collection. Bigger wines need bigger bowls. That's the basic logic behind it. If you have a big wine with a lot of body, a lot of aromatics, it needs to have some air to get it to open up. Oftentimes these are going to be red wines, but not always. A big barrel fermented Chardonnay like this one here is going to go perfect in this larger bowl Pinot Noir stem. So I have a Pinot Noir here, I have a barrel fermented Chardonnay here. I also love to drink Grenache wines out of these. Anything that has lots of aromatics and is a fuller bodied wine, like a barrel fermented white wine, so it could be a Fumé Blanc as well. But any larger wine that needs to have some air to open up, but the difference between this glass and this glass is for those wines that don't have a lot of big, beefy, drying tannins. So not Cabernet Sauvignon, not Malbec. That's going to be this next glass here. This is going to be more for those Grenaches, for the Pinot Noirs, and for those barrel fermented whites like a Chardonnay or a Fumé Blanc. So this glass here, the Pinot Noir stem, is perfect with barrel fermented oak aged whites and lower tannin dry reds. So I use the word tannin. Now what are tannins? Tannins are something that are in mostly red wines, but white wines that get barrel fermented also have a little bit of tannin as well because it comes from the oak. Tannin is what gives a wine body, but when you have more tannin, it also creates the impression of bitterness or a drying sensation on your palate. So if you think about those Cabernet Sauvignons, maybe you haven't liked them as much as a Merlot, and that's because Merlot has lower tannin. It tends to dry your mouth out a little bit less. Pinot Noir, even less than Merlot. Sweetness can really balance tannins, so a lot of these sweet red blends that are in the market today use sugar to bring down the impression of bitterness so that people will enjoy them more. So if you're not a fan of dry, tannic, slightly bitter wines, then stay over on this side with your sweet reds and things along that line. And now the last shape that we have. Again, larger bowl for a bigger wine, but here you can see that the top is a little bit narrower on this glass here. And what that ends up doing is wines coming out of this glass are gonna hit your tongue in a much more focused manner. They're gonna go straight down the middle of your tongue. On this glass, they're gonna go more broadly across the entire tongue. So when you have lower tannins, you want to distribute the wine across your tongue. When you have higher tannins, you wanna focus it more directly so those tannins don't seem as bitter. So this glass is perfect for that. Big red wines with lots of tannin, like a Malbec or a Cabernet Sauvignon, Syrah, Nebbiolo, Barolo, Sangiovese, Rioja, all of those wines are perfect in a glass like this. So just to recap, four shapes are all you really need to have. Two would be ideal if you want to have just the minimum. If you have just two, make sure you have a sparkling wine flute for all of your sparkling wines and a standard white wine or all-purpose wine glass. That's perfect to stop right there. But if you want to continue on for some of your bigger wines, then a Pinot Noir or a Burgundy shape for your barrel fermented whites and your lower tannin reds, and then a Cabernet Sauvignon or a Bordeaux stem for your heavier bodied, more full tannin reds like your Malbecs and your Cabernets, your Merlots, things along those lines. So we've covered a lot of ground in today's video, and if it was too much for you to remember, I understand. That's why if you just look below this video screen here on the website, you'll see an icon where you can download and print out your own version of our Get Mo Wine Essential Glassware Grid. Each thing that I talked about today with the different shapes and sizes and the different wines to go with them are on that card. So there you have it. Those are the four shapes that we keep at the Dodd household. And I hope that you will enjoy drinking your wine out of whichever ones you choose. For now, that's it for Pat Dodd, the Wine Dodd, and a Get Mo Wine Essential Glassware.